Hello filmmakers, welcome to Storitium. Today we're going to create this awesome character introduction effect in Adobe Premiere Pro. This one is inspired by the character introduction effect that was used in the film Snatch, directed by Guy Ritchie. He used this effect very effectively to introduce the characters in this film. And in case you're wondering why this tutorial looks a little familiar, that's because I made a similar tutorial back in 2019. That video had more than 1 million views, but sadly I had to take it down related to the name change of my channel. But because that tutorial was so popular, I had to make a new improved version. So I hope you'll also enjoy this one. Inside Premiere, I've already got the clip on the timeline that we're going to use for this tutorial. First, I'm going to scrub through the timeline and find the point that we want to freeze. I think that this one will do. Now we can cut the track at this point. And to do this, I'm going to switch to the eraser tool by hitting the C key and then cut the track at the point of the playhead. And after that, I can switch back to the selection tool by hitting the V key. I also want to freeze motion at this point of the timeline, so I'm going to right click on the cutoff part and then select Add Frame Hold. And this option will freeze the rest of the video at the current frame. Next, I will duplicate the second part by holding the Alt key combined with the left mouse button and then drag the video one track up. For the next step, make sure you've got the top layer selected and then head over to the Effects Control Panel. And in here, in the Opacity section, we're going to click on this pen icon, which is also known as the Free Draw Bezier tool. And now we can draw a mask, but first we need to zoom in to be able to work more precisely. 200% should be good enough to start drawing the mask around our subject, the woman on the bicycle. In this case, I'm going to start with her right arm and then add as much points as needed by left-clicking in the program monitor. Just take your time and make the mask fit as good as possible. But for now, I will speed up this part so you don't have to wait. Okay, two more points to add and the first mask is done. And if I set the monitor back to fit, you can see the mask that we just created. And you can also see that the handlebar is not included in the mask. But we could add them by making two more small masks. First, let's zoom back to 200% and then move over to the point that we need to add. We can now simply click on the pen icon to create the second mask. And then again, use the left mouse button to add mask points and draw a mask over the handlebar. Okay, that's the second mask, now we need to add one more for the other side of the handlebar. And as you can see, we've now got three masks listed here in the effects control panel. For the next steps, I'm going to set the program monitor back to fit. Next, I'm going to change the feathering options to 0 pixels for all the masks. And that's because this effect will look a lot better without feathering. Next, we're going to animate the masks. We're going to enable keyframes for scaling and position by clicking on the stopwatch icon here. Then move a couple of frames forward and zoom in by changing the scaling option. And if it looks better, you can also play around with the position. And if you're happy with the results, you can move the keyframes to the end of the clip. But now after scaling and repositioning, the background is a little distracting. But we can fix this by adding two effects. In the effects panel, I'm going to search for the Gaussian blur effect. I'm going to apply this effect to the cutoff part, the bottom layer, and then move over to the effects control panel. And in here we're going to set blurriness to 100 and we'll also enable repeat edge pixels. And the second effect that we're going to add is the black and white effect. And this does exactly what it sounds like, it makes the clip black and white. With these two effects on the background layer and some keyframes on the mask, this is what we've created so far. Before we continue to the next part of this tutorial, I want to give a huge shout out to the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is a great source for all your creative projects. They offer millions of high quality items like stock videos and images, music and sound effects, but also many transition templates and presets. If you want to try them out, then use the link in the video description to claim a discount on your first month. The links can be found in the video description. Okay, back to the tutorial. For the next steps, we first need to nest the layer that contains the mask. We can do this by right-clicking on the layer and then select Nest. Then give the nested sequence a name and click OK. Okay, a nested sequence created, we can now add some effects to it. In the effects panel, I'm going to search for the radial shadow effect. I'm going to apply this effect to the nested layer that contains the mask, and as you can see, this has now created a bit of a shadow. But in this case, we don't want a shadow, we want to add a hard outline or a stroke around our subject. And we can do this by playing around with the radial shadow effect in the effects control panel. I'm going to start by changing opacity to 100%, and I'm also going to select white instead of black. And next we can reposition the shadow by playing around with the light source values. I'm going to try to make it somewhat equal on all sides of the subject. In case the outline is still too thick or too small, then play around with projection distance, or you can also try to enable the resize layer option. In the next steps, we're going to add some optional items in the background. Let's start by making some room for some new layers by moving the nested sequence layer a few tracks up. The first layer that I'm going to add are some ink splashes or blots. I've got a lot of them here in this folder, which I found on Envato Elements. I will link them in the video description. You can probably also find similar images elsewhere, but be sure to use images that include transparency, like a PNG file for example. Anyway, for this demo I'm going to use this ink stroke background image. I will place this on the second track and extend the duration. And as you can see, this ink stroke is now visible between the background and the woman riding the bicycle. And on the other track we're going to add some text. We can do this with the type tool, which you can enable here, or hit the T key to enable it. And because this is stock footage from Envato Elements, I don't know her name. So let's type something fancy, like the cyclist. And then inside the Essential Graphics panel, I'm going to change the size of the text and also the space between the lines. And then move back to the selection tool and then reposition the text. And as I mentioned, this text layer should be on the third track. This will bring it behind the main subject and before the background. And of course, we also need to extend the text layer on the timeline. In the next step, I'm going to change the color of the ink stroke. In the effects panel, we're going to search for the change to color effect. And I'll apply this effect to the ink background layer. In the effects control panel, we're going to select black for the from color, and we're going to pick the pink color from her shirt for the to color. And then set change to hue, lightness and saturation. And there you have it, the black ink has been changed to pink. In the next steps, we're going to animate the background and the text. First, I'm going to select the background ink layer and then enable keyframes for scaling in the effects control panel. And then lower the scaling value to zoom out. And I'm going to move that keyframe to the end of the video. Then slightly increase scaling to zoom in and create another keyframe, and move that keyframe to the beginning. And then I will also enable keyframes for rotation. And in this case, I'm going to put the first keyframe at the beginning and then change the value and put the second keyframe at the end. And now this ink background layer is rotating and zooming out, and that's the opposite of the main subject, which zooms in. We're going to do the same for the text layer. We're going to select it on a timeline and then enable keyframes for scaling and rotation. Then move the first keyframes to the beginning, then change the values and move the keyframes to the end. And these keyframes and effects all together look something like this. Okay, and let's move to the final step for this tutorial. We're going to add a simple dip to white transition, and to do this we first need to nest all the layers. So I will select all the layers, then right click and select nest. Then give the nested sequence a name and click OK. And then inside the effects panel we're going to search for the dip to white effect. I'm going to add this transition to the clips, and then inside the effects control panel set it to center. And I should also mention that you might need to render the effects first for some smooth playback on the timeline, as you can see here by this red line. You can render the effects by hitting the Enter key and then Premiere will start rendering. And then after rendering, we can have a look at the final result. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you want to see more similar tutorials, then check out one of these two. Anyway, as always, thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.